Random House Audible presents The Action Hero's Handbook. How to catch a great white shark, perform the Jedi mind trick, track a fugitive, and dozens of other TV and movie skills. By David Borgenicht and Joe Borgenicht. Read for you by Gerard Doyle. Introduction. Action heroes are made, not born. Even those with superpowers and precocious talents had to start somewhere. After all, did you really think that Superman could always leap tall buildings in a single bound? That James Bond always knew to drink martinis shaken, not stirred? Or that Indiana Jones was born with a whip in his hand instead of a rattle? Of course not. Every action hero shows a clear aptitude for heroism, but needs guidance along the way. In the beginning, every action hero is just an ordinary but good man or woman. The hero must first identify and then hone his skills and talents. Then, before he achieves hero status, he'll have to overcome a series of obstacles, physical, emotional, or paranormal. And somehow, through the cumulative effect of his upbringing, good or bad, formative life experiences, an apprenticeship, and the occasional bite of a radioactive insect, his inner action hero eventually comes to the surface. But even after he saved his first dude or damsel in distress, or thwarted his first plot for world domination, there are times when the most accomplished action heroes still need a little help. No man or woman is an island, and this applies to secret agents, hot private detectives in catsuits, capable Vulcans and Jedi Knights, and rugged archaeologists alike. That's where this audio program comes in. This audio program truly is your guide to keeping up with the Indiana Joneses. It's the only primer on the essential skills all action heroes must know to survive and thrive in this dangerous world. Good guy skills, love skills, paranormal skills, fighting skills, escape skills, all from real experts in the subject at hand. The skills we teach have all been featured in television shows and movies. But before now, you've never been able to hear a real-world, step-by-step how-to guide to these skills. Let us reiterate. All of the information in this audio program is completely real. Want to know how to really catch a great white shark? To actually deliver a Vulcan nerve pinch? To spy-proof your hotel room? To win a fight when outnumbered? To climb down Mount Rushmore National Monument? It's all inside. We spoke with FBI agents, sexologists, stuntmen, hypnotists, karate masters, criminologists, detectives, and dozens of other highly trained professionals to obtain real-world solutions to the kinds of situations that usually only happen to people with very cool names, unusually tight clothing, and few, if any, sweat glands. So use the information wisely. And whatever you do, don't let this audio program fall into the wrong hands. Listen on, and good luck. We're counting on you. The authors. Chapter 1. Good Guy Skills. The most basic skills an action hero needs are commonly referred to as good guy skills. These are the abilities needed to protect yourself from your enemies as you set off on your mission, whether you're entering a hotel room, driving a bus that has been turned into a bomb, or being held hostage in a Los Angeles skyscraper. You need these skills to protect yourself first, then to save others, and finally to catch the bad guys. Before you start your training, you should decide how you like to work. Are you a loner, or would you rather have a buddy along? Are you a veteran, or do you need rookie guidance? Would you rather be in the line of fire, or in the line at the wedding? Once you've answered these questions, you'll better understand your limitations and be able to select which skills best apply to the situation at hand. So listen on and learn. It's a dangerous world out there. But with the skills you'll master in this section, you should be able to make it out alive. How to secure or spy-proof a hotel room.
Aren't you in the wrong room, Mr. Bond?
Not from where I'm standing.
Thunderball.
The first stop on your mission is often the hotel where you'll be staying, but unfortunately, the hotel room is where the travelling action hero is often most exposed. And no matter what the movies suggest, you can't always expect an intruder to be a scantily clad femme fatale or Brad Pitt type who wants to engage in a bit of pre-execution lovemaking, thereby conveniently giving you the opportunity to sway her or his allegiance. Although it does happen that way from time to time. Be aware, maintenance and hotel workers regularly gain access to your room, and thus, so can your enemies. With that in mind, here's what to do. According to Sean Engbrecht of the Center for Advanced Security Studies. Pre-arrival and arrival tips. Reserve several rooms under several different names. Using several aliases can make it difficult for your enemy to know which room to invade. Play the shell game. Stay in a different room every other night, or so. Reserve your room or rooms on at least the 6th or 7th floor of the hotel. This will make it difficult for anything to be thrown into your room from the ground. Avoid cabana-style hotels that are only on ground level. Ground floor entry is the easiest to gain. Try to obtain rooms on a side of the hotel that stands higher than the other buildings. Avoid staying in a room that has other rooms overlooking it, which could make it easier for someone to gain entry through a window or balcony, keep tabs on you from across the way, or give a sniper a good angle. Never use the hotel's main entrance and avoid using the main elevators or stairs. Use service entrances, exits, and freight elevators as frequently as possible. If you can't use those, try to enter and exit the hotel through an underground garage, side or pool entrance, delivery door, or kitchen. Avoid the hotel lobby whenever possible. Entering the room. Ideally, you should be prepared to use some sort of implement, blunt object, weapon, in case you interrupt the intruder. Carry a flashlight or night vision goggles so that you won't need to fumble for light switches as you enter the room. Step 1. Stand toward the hinge side of the doorframe, not in the center or on the side with the doorknob. This stance will protect you from an attack immediately upon entry or from a gun fired at the door from inside the room. Step 2. Throw the door open quickly and forcefully so that it hits the wall behind it. You'll quickly discover whether someone is standing directly behind the door. Either the door will not open all the way, or you will obtain audible evidence of the intruder's existence. Step 3. Leave the door open until you have cleared the room. If someone is inside, it's always better to give him a way out to avoid a confrontation. You should, however, be ready for confrontation at a moment's notice. Step 4. Enter the room with your back to the wall nearest to the entry door. This will make you less of an easy target. Step 5. Keeping your back against the wall, move quickly around the perimeter of the room, scanning up and down and from side to side. Move clockwise around the room, entering bedrooms, bathrooms, and closets as you come to them. Open the doors as in steps 1 and 2, and secure each room in turn. You may need to use a flashlight or night vision goggles to check these spaces. If you use night vision goggles, be sure to keep one eye free. If the goggles are exposed to a light source, the resulting whiteout will render you temporarily blind. Step 6. If you are about to pass by windows, draw the curtains before you pass. Continue with your sweep until you are back where you started. Step 7. Next, check out any potential hiding places. The most common hiding places are under the bed or beds and in closets and showers. Step 8. Look for surveillance devices. Today's miniature technology makes it very difficult to find high-tech bugs, but a basic sweep may turn up a listening device or two. Check under lampshades and lamp bases, under furniture, inside the heating or air conditioning units, in the telephone receiver, and on the telephone line. Look for anything out of the ordinary. Simple devices like the traditional round bug in the receiver will be easy to recognize, but are very rarely used by sophisticated eavesdroppers. Answering the door. Avoid standing directly in front of the door. Stand to the hinge side of the door. Never open the door without verifying the person's identity. Ask any alleged hotel employee to slide his or her ID badge under the door.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.